Hey, this is Sebastian from the Metal Gods Meltdown, and I'm joined by...
This is Villa from Morsbury's Breast.
Embers of a Dying World is awesome. How are you feeling now? Are you anxious or excited as release date approaches?
Well, it's been, 10 months since we finished the album, so, it's about time to get the album out.
It's an interesting title for the album and theme throughout. Can you tell me where you guys draw your ideas and inspirations from?
The title is just a title. We discussed with Andy about what should we name the album, and he had his ideas, I had my ideas, and we didn't seem to find the middle ground that we both liked. So at some point, can't remember which one was it, but at some point this title came up and we both agreed on it. So we decided to call it that. I don't know what was the inspiration or anything, but just came somewhere, and that's the story.
You've released a couple of tracks. What's the general response been like to the new songs?
I think people have liked them, mostly. Of course, there's always one or two person that thinks Inhumanity is the best album, so I don't pay that much attention to those, but I mean, yeah, you can't please everybody, that's for sure, and that's something we have always known, so... Doesn't matter if we say 95% of the opinions have been positive, so then we're happy.
Okay, the album gets released on the 25th this month in Japan. Why does Japan get an early release? Because it doesn't get out to the 10th everywhere else.
Well, it's just something that they demand in the contract. So I think with every... Well, I don't know if for with every band, but I mean, it's a normal thing that if you sign with a Japanese label for a Japanese market and then you have a different label in Europe and USA...
Mm-hmm.
Then the Japanese labels, they demand, you know, it's in the contract that they are the ones that will first release the albums, because they think that their CDs, they cost so much that if they would release it at the same time than the other ones, then I guess they fear that the Japanese people would just order the album abroad, so... I don't know. That's what I think, but I don't know if it's true. But I think it's just normal that the Japanese labels, they demand one extra bonus song and or two, whatever the contract says. But it is normal that the Japanese label release it before anyone else.
You've got a hell of a fan base over there in Japan and China, haven't you?
Yeah, I mean, it seems. I didn't know anything about China before we went there last fall, but I mean, yeah, we had really good fan base, it seems so. And in Japan, of course, we've been doing there almost every year, so yeah, it's fucking great.
We'll be right back. which is also the band's name in Latin. Can you give me some feedback about this particular song, and who is the female singer?
Well, she's Christina Mary. I think she was in The Voice of the UK or something like that, you know. Yeah, I think she was in there a couple of years ago, and I think she was like number 2 or 3 or something like that, like bronze medalist or something, I don't know. But Andy knew her from somewhere, and Andy, when I was thinking about that, the option that we could have some clean vocals on that song, and then Andy said that, okay, I know this girl, or I know about this girl. What do I think? And blah blah blah. I made her do demo vocals, and then when I heard her demos, I said to Andy that okay, I'm cool with it. So that's how she came in, and I told Andy that maybe he could write a slow song. So I think that's how we came up with the slow idea for that song.
Which two tracks would you play me to introduce me to your band from the new album if I was totally new to Moors?
If I would like to represent the band and not the new album, that's two different things, because back catalogue is a bit different than the new album, so it's kind of hard. Should I? If I would only focus on the new album, if I would like to introduce a new guy to a new, for this new album, I think I would most likely choose Reclaim the Sun and Apprentice of Death, but if I would think about the whole band, you know, with the back catalog and everything, then I don't know, Reclaim the Sun maybe, because that's kind of sounds more, it's, you know, more this traditional Morse song, if, you know, if I would have to choose one traditional song from the new album. And then, I don't know, it's kind of a hard one. Yeah, I don't, maybe. The Colors of the Cosmos, maybe, I don't know.
Okay.
I don't know if it's a hard one, I don't know.
The artwork is always really eye-catching and stunning for your albums. Do you have any of the work displayed at your home?
No, not me. I mean, Andy. Andy has, he has the albums framed on his wall, but I just have them in my closet or somewhere.
You played, like we've said, a lot of gigs in Asia, specifically Japan and China. How different is it over there from the crowds in Europe?
I don't think it's that much different. I mean, yeah, they are, you know, the Japanese fans, they pretty much are like real fucking aggressive. Not in a negative way aggressive, but they are like so into this, like the European fans, they are kind of, yeah, I like this band and blah, blah, blah. And then you might see them after the show or before show and they're good show. And that's it. But, you know, the Japanese fans, they, you know, they more live, you know, this fucking music. You know, your band is their fucking... I was told that because in Japan, you have to work so much, you don't have a lot of, you know, free time. So free time that they use, it's pretty much in only one thing. So if they decide that I'm going to use my free time in music and in this band, then they, you know, do it 100%. So after work, it's that fucking music and that band. So it depends whatever band it is, it doesn't matter still. So they are real fans. So I mean, it was first time when we went there, this about 40-year-old guy, he started to cry.
Really?
And that was, yeah, that was really like, what the fuck? I mean, but for them, it's a lot bigger thing, you know, than, I would, you know, the in Europe and in United States, I think you need to have like a band like Metallica before people really go fucking crazy, you know, actually cry. You don't cry if you see, you know, Amot from Arch Enemy, but you could cry if you see James Hetfield. So it's the same in Japan, but it's just, you don't, they don't need the bands to be that fucking high level. It doesn't matter. Whatever band it is that they love, then it is. It's, that band is as big as Metallica.
are the plans for the tour-wise and festival-wise for 2017?
Well, at the moment, only the 70,000 tons of metal, that's the only one. Oh, yeah, and one summer festival, but I still can't talk about that one because they haven't released our name and blah, 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 blah. It's just to be. But other than that, I mean, yeah, we most likely return to Asia at the end of this year.
Do you think you'll get over to England at all for a tour?
I have no idea. I mean, yeah, of course, we hope that we will get a European tour and North America's tour, but and also South America, but it's there's nothing concrete. But the Asia tour is, it's pretty, it's not 100% sure, but I'm not sure that we will go back to Asia. We also try to get to Australia.
Cool.
This time also, but that's pretty much a money situation, so we'll have to see how's the financial things going. But I do hope that we get Europe and North America also.
What can we expect from Amor's live show?
We don't, you know, have any fancy tricks or gadgets or anything. It's just, you know, five guys playing the music that we do, and we try to play as good as we can, because there are some bands that they, you know, they don't care how they play as long as they fucking headbang as much as they can. So we kind of try to take the both, you know, we try to, you know, be something else than just stand on the stage and focus on what we do. We, of course, we try to have something going on the stage, but also we, for us, it is important that we play the songs well. So, you know, it's people that comes to see the shows and they want to hear the songs, so we want to play the songs good. Otherwise, it's just, I don't like to go see bands and they play shit. I want to hear good songs.
Can you tell me what has been your proudest moment to date with Moors?
I don't know if it's a cliche or not, but when we got the first recording deal, that I think that was the proudest moment of my history in Moors. Something that every young guy, when they start their band, they always, someday I'm gonna get signed. So, and then when this happened, that was fucking cool.
If I was totally new to heavy metal, which two albums would you give me to introduce me to the music?
Oh my god, I don't know, I can't name the albums, but I would give you something from Hypocrisy and Old Man's Child, for example, and maybe, let's see what else, well, maybe Morris also.
Of course.
Yeah, but I mean, yeah, let's say, well, yeah, maybe Metallica and Megadeth also.
Can you sum up the mood in the band today?
Our mood is, I don't know what they were. We're happy.
All right, so just a quick fire, Ryan, now. Small, intimate gig or festival?
Festival.
Vinyl or CD?
For me, CD.
Lapland, because you're Finnish, or Lap Dancing Club?
Well, Lap Dancing Club.
Sauna or beer?
As I don't drink alcohol, basically, I also have to say sauna.
And last one, Putin or Trump?
Oh, fuck. I have to say George W.
That's cheating.
Yeah.
Can you tell us why we should buy your album?
Well, if you want to hear good fucking melodic death metal, then you should buy it.
Give us some final words for your fans and our listeners.
Well, yeah, I mean, if you guys out there, I hope that you guys go and check out the new album, and if you do like the sound of the new album, I hope you buy the album, because without any record sales, it's kind of hard for us to be able to play for you guys in UK. So the more sales we have, the more shows we get. So hi, this is Ville from Moors Prison Best. You're listening to Metal God's Meltdown. We'll be right back.
Change the past. This is the road to doom.